Hi, Job Seekers! Alam niyo ba na may tamang paraan ng pagsagot sa question na how much is your expected salary? Watch this video dahil makakasama natin si Ma'am Shelo Marte Presas na isang executive coach, senior HR executive, experienced HR project manager, happiness and life coach, and isa sa mga top 100 Filipino professionals for learning and development ng isang sikat na website para tulungan tayo kung paano sagutin ang tanong na how much is your expected salary? Ma'am Shelo, bakit po ba ito tinatanong palagi ng mga recruiter sa interview?
We ask that because we have a budget. So, if your answer falls within our budget, it's more probable that you will be taken in. If you will be answering the question with a higher rate, so there's a good chance that you will not be going through the next process. You will have two candidates. Then one candidate will be telling you the rate is within your budget, and another one will probably be saying, bahala na po kayo, and then the third one will be saying a higher rate. Between the three, which one will you choose? The one which will have the higher probability of being taken in, and that's the person within the budget, okay? So, yun. It's not because a lot of people are saying that they're just they're just asking it around. Some people are saying, wala lang, they're just asking about it. But the truth is, we use it as a gauge on which ones we will be picking. So yun. So are you first priority, second priority, third priority? So that's how we do it.
Ano pong mas maganda isagot sa recruiter? Fixed amount or salary range?
So if it's a change, I would suggest you do a fixed. So it's claro. If you're giving a range, sa totoong buhay lang, pag tinanong ka ng range, you're actually meaning the higher is, di ba? So, sasabihin mo, ay, between 20 to 25, but actually, you're looking at 25. Kung pinigyan ka ng 20, sasabihin mo, baba naman, pag pinigay sa akin, so ayoko na. So, recruitment is a job. So, recruiters will find ways in order to make their life easier as well. So, you will have one person who's going to give you a range, one person who's going to give you a fixed amount. Who will you prefer to talk to initially? Di ba? Mas magandang kausapin mo na yung naka-fixed amount within your budget rather than a person who has given you a range. First priority yung naka-fixed kasi, okay na to. And then yung naka-range pa, baka second priority mo na lang, let's see. So that's how it's being played.
Ilan percent increase from my current salary ang acceptable sa mga recruiters?
If you'll be joining another company, the going rate for some is about 10 to 20% higher. So initially, you have to do your market research as well. You have to know how much your rate is outside. So when you apply and then you are into the negotiation of rate, you have to know how much other companies of similar business are paying. What I mean is, the market is diverse. You have those in government service, those who are in BPOs, high tech, and then there the banking industry as well, the general industry. If you're comparing your pay, for example, you're an IT person, the pay in the bank is different from a pay in a development company. So it's different. So you might be the same when it comes to profession, but because of the nature of the business, it's going to be different.
And that's it, Job Seekers! Thank you for watching this video at sana ay natulungan namin kayo kung paano sagutin ang interview question na ito on your next interview. Once again, this is Ayira Pirat from morethanjobs.com.ph, and for interview tips, job openings, and more, please do subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on our social media pages, and you may apply on our website, that's www.morethanjobs.com.ph. Till next time, job seekers! Bye!